Bom dia, capoeiristas. Hello, todo mundo. Ponceninho falando aqui. This video will be mainly in English. Esse vídeo vai ser mais em inglês, porque esse livro é um livro que, é claro, o manuscrito do Mestre Pastinha, ele está em português, né? Então, as pessoas têm muito acesso a isso. Então, eu estou fazendo esse vídeo explicando aqui para os meus alunos que e não conhecem, ok? But if you speak Portuguese, stay around. Se você fala português, fica aí. Dá uma olhada nas fotos, em algumas coisas que eu vou falar, tá bom? Even though I'm speaking in English, it would be nice for those who speak Portuguese only to stay here and to appreciate. Então, para quem fala português, para ficar e apreciar também esse lindo livro aqui. Então, esse livro, this book, is called Improviso de Pastinha. I love the name straight away, Improviso de Pastinha. It's a beautiful photo of Mestre Pastinha there. I decided to do this video, guys, because I have a reasonably good library of capoeira books here in the UK. I still have some books in Brazil. It's quite nice because when I go to Brazil, it's very nostalgic to go to my sister's house. My sister kept most of my stuff. And it's really nostalgic to go there and to pick up some stuff from my journey as a practitioner first, and also as a teacher, as a mestre, some of my collections, né? And this stuff is important for you to come back again and again to it. So the first thing to notice here is this beautiful cover, and you can see the beautiful penmanship. That's obviously his signature, his name written down. And this book is by Organização Fred Abreu. Now, this is a name for you guys to really research. If anybody have not looked into Fred Abreu, he left a really important legacy, considered a great capoeira intellectual, a great historian in terms of capoeira, and well, not just in capoeira, but in relation to capoeira. He left us some really important work, okay? This is a tiny work, but it's a small work with a lot of meaning behind. Obviously, we don't judge a book by a cover or even by its amount of pages. And this book here by Fred Abreu is, I like the fact that, just going back a little bit, it's based on the manuscripts of Mestre Pastinha. And I love the fact that they decided to call it Improvisation of Mestre Pastinha. There's something for me, I read quite poetic about that. So if I start, I'm sure you want to me to just turn that page. If I go into the first page, so I am not going to be reading the book to you, because obviously I'm interested in you one day, if possible, having the book. Now, I am going to leave in the description ways to look for it when I find, because to be honest, I have been looking for ways that this book could be shipped and sent. And I spoke to some of my friends about this, people that have great contact with the organization, and they are helping me. And as soon as I have any news on how to purchase the book, I will let you know. I'm just going to forward the information for you guys, so you probably have to come back to the description later. So look at that, how beautiful that first page. Now here we're just going to read a little bit of the ficha técnica. So arcevo means kind of the archive of Fred Abreu. And then what a few things to consider here that is important is the translation, of course, because I chose this book because it's translated in English. And that's a really important part for anybody who is learning capoeira outside Brazil. The translation is by Luisa Pimenta. She says here her nickname, I presume, Lilu. And in here, you see, this is quite funny. There's like a 99p stick in there. What I love about this, this is the folder the Mestre João Grande kept the manuscript. And it says here, let me see if I can get this for you guys. It's the first time I'm doing this kind of video. I'm not sure how good it is. So, folder where João Grande keeps the improvisation of Pastinha. Isn't that beautiful? I really like that. So, I can just, something that he kept with a lot of treasure. So here there's a beautiful photo of Mestre Pastinha and Mestre João Grande playing the berimbau together. And so just to unpack a little bit, another photo of Mestre Pastinha. here in 1940. Yes? Now, why am I showing this, apart from just showing Mes Pastinha, is that if you look on the internet for 1940 Mes Pastinha, it's where you get that beautiful video of Mes Pastinha playing, which for me, it's a video that was so wonderful to see, because obviously I grew up, guys, I don't know if it happened to you as well, but I grew up my entire, most of my time as a capoeirista, the one thing we never knew, we could never tell, it's how did Mes Pastinha play capoeira and how did Mestre Bimba play capoeira. This has always been the biggest mystery for us. And there are so many stories about how incredible they were, how amazing they were. Now, of course, even if there was a couple of videos of them, it could have been in one phase and not in another. So if the videos were taken when they, maybe at a later stage of their career, would it be one representation of how they played? How did they play earlier in their career? We might never know. However, when the video first came out of Mes Pastinha playing, I'm going to be honest with you, I was even more excited than I thought. I thought he's actually better than I could imagine that he was. When I really look the way he moves, the underneath negativas, the beauty, that really soft energy, to be honest with you, I actually was even more impressed than I thought I would be. So that's why I pose on this photo here. Now I want to read just a couple of bits from the book for you. I like this part here that says, three languages in a roda. Portuguese, English, and capoeira. That's nice, because capoeira is a language, right? Translating Mes Pastinha to English was more than exercising grammar and looking for right meanings. It was text and context comprehension and noticing the great poet that he was, / he is. His poetry must go around the world. So obviously it's wonderful to hear that she's saying it wasn't just about, I wasn't translating a book of instructions, I was translating poetry. It is indeed a very poetic book. And now when we open here, we start to see some of the beautiful writings of Mes Pastinha, the penmanship, some really powerful stuff that teaches a lot about capoeira. Now here's one that is really important, okay? So, and when we think about this bit here that he wrote, it's part of a song, part of a ladainha, and that we hear other people sing as ladainha. And it says, I was in my house, estava na minha casa, without thinking, without imagining, when Salomão called me to win the war of Paraguay. So when someone knocked on the door and Salomão called me to win the war of Paraguay. Now, what is interesting about this part here is the fact that he's talking about the war of Paraguay. Now, why is that interesting for us? Because the War of Paraguay, if we look at the time where Mes Pastinha was born and when Mes Pastinha was around, this precise time between monarchy and republic in Brazil, it's a time that we have a lot of musical reference in capoeira that we sing to this day, comes from all of this time. These were times where there was a lot of provincial wars happening in Brazil, in Bahia, lots of revolts happening all the time. And in a lot of these, capoeiristas were very much involved. Obviously, capoeiristas were involved in the War of Paraguay. Now, Paraguay wasn't a provincial revolt. The War of Paraguay was a very sad, very bloody war. Obviously, wars are very sad, but this one particularly, it is accounted to be one of the wars that most cost lives of civilians. And soldiers, of course. And when we hear the song, sou eu, Maitá, sou eu, Maitá, sou eu, Maitá, it is a direct reference to this. So it's an important historical wars, an important historical fact that happened that we need to study a little bit more, just to start to be familiar with music references. Capoeiristas were sent to that war. So if I just go into the translation part here, the translation part, and this is kind of the main point what I wanted to show you guys. So I am going to zoom in this a little bit more. There we go. Sorry, phone is shaking here a little bit. So it says, friend, don't get suspicious. What I do plain, you only do it angry. You are vain. You are resentful. In capoeira, you got eliminated. Now, this is for me is a masterpiece because this is philosophy, moral teaching. It goes into the physicality, it goes into the emotions. What is really beautiful about this is that he's saying there's a few things to consider here from my approach to this. This is obviously poetry, so we can have different interpretations. Now, I like when he says, "You in capoeira, you got eliminated." He's not saying, "I am going to eliminate you because of the way you are." He's almost saying, these are feelings that will get you eliminated, that will not help you. These are not helpful feelings. So I like the fact that capoeira becomes the entity that drives this kind of behavior out. And when he's saying, "What I do playing, you only do it angry." What he's saying is, I can do things easy. You have to get into a state. You have to get into right state in your body and, you know, and breathe too hard and be anxious or angry to be able to do what I do. In other words, he's saying, I am effortless. And you use a lot of effort. And why? Because you are vain. So you have too much vanity, which is interesting because in another verse he says, don't have vanity, but also don't let yourself go. Find that middle ground where it's okay to look after yourself. We need to look after ourselves. We just want to be careful with overdoing, of course. And then he comes perhaps the most powerful part where he says you are resentful. So resentment is considered to be the absolutely worst feeling you can have because it just dries up the artist, it dries up the capoeirista. I believe that could be related to many other forms of movement, but certainly with movement in capoeira, this is a feeling that if it's at play, your mind is going to be completely muddled, perhaps confused, and it doesn't help you to find your creativity, doesn't help you to find inspiration, doesn't help you to find your share. So I love the fact that right here in Mestre Pastinha's writing, you can see in what we've got here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lines here. Perhaps could be more when he in Portuguese, that there's a lot to unpack, there's a lot to discuss. So I just wanted to show you the book and talk a little bit about. There's a beautiful photo of Mestre João Grande here. And then here you can see there, Arcevo Fred Abreu. Take a look at this reference. What is nice here is that when I go into the last page, you see here, and let me just look for you. Here we go, guys. The War of Paraguay, 1864-1870, had Brazil, Argentina, and Uruguay against Paraguay. For this war, capoeiristas were recruited. So capoeiristas were sent to this war. And there's a little, so you see the references from words such as dendê, oil, coconut oil, gengibirra. This is another one to be researched for you guys. The road the Mestre Pastinha went, a symbolic place of capoeira Angola. Important messages went there. So there we go. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you liked this, if it was helpful, if it was something that you enjoy. If it is, I would very much start to bring you some of my other books and show you some of the beautiful things that I kept here in my house. Thank you very much. Axé.